Hey everyone, to demonstrate this torn paper effect, I have two clips here that I'm going to use, and I'm actually going to focus on the second clip here real quick. So what I'm going to do right now is to just take the first second of this clip, which is going to be about 24 frames in my case, and then I'm going to create a marker here, and then let's just push it to the second track, make sure this marker lines up with the end of the first clip, and then let's make a quick cut. And now what I'm going to do is to convert this small clip here into a fusion clip. And now we are ready to take it to the fusion page. So on the fusion page, the first thing we're going to do is to bring a matte control node. And then along with that, we're also going to bring a polygon masking node. However, before we connect polygon masking node to matte control node, I'm actually going to start draw a mask on the screen first. And I will start doing that in the middle of this clip, which I know is a bit unconventional, but the reason is just because once the mask is drawn, it's much easier to go back to the beginning and the end. So to demonstrate, what I'm going to do right now is just to start to draw a mask on the screen right now that resembles a paper cut. And you will also see that this automatically creates a keyframe for us in the inspector panel there. And once this is done, let's just right click polygon and then drop it on top of matte control, and in this menu let's make sure to select garbage matte. Now let's come to the inspector panel here for matte control, double click garbage matte, and then select invert. Now as I mentioned earlier, once this is done, it is much easier to go to the beginning and the end of this clip. So to demonstrate, let's just come to the beginning of this clip right here and then select all these points, and then all we're gonna do is just to push them to the left until they are out of the screen. So now let's come to the end of this clip, do the opposite. We're just gonna push them over to the right, and you will see that this will also automatically create a keyframe for us as well. So now you see that we have a very smooth swipe motion for our paper cut. However, this paper cut look at this point is too homogeneous throughout this entire clip. And in order to fix that, what we're gonna do is to simply adjust the positions of these points on the screen throughout different parts of this clip. So for example, right now, we're at the beginning of this clip. I'm just simply changing up how these points are positioned on the screen, and we're gonna do this throughout the rest of this clip. This is where you can get super creative and have some fun with it. You know, you don't have to necessarily follow exactly what I'm doing here, but the idea is just that we're going to give this paper cut effect a slightly different look, a different style throughout different points in this clip. And the best part is that whenever you do this, if it doesn't have a keyframe at that point in the clip, it will automatically set up a keyframe for you, and that is something beneficial about using polygon masking node. So once this is done, you can see that it's going to almost look like it will have a shape morph for this paper look effect throughout this entire clip, and it looks just way more natural and better than what we had before. All right, so now we're ready to move on to the next step by bringing the paper edge effect, which you can find under templates, edit, effects. And once it's connected to matte control node, you're gonna see that it's going to give you this paper effect right away. However, it doesn't look that great right off the bat. There are a few things that I wanna fix, one of which is just the fact that this rugged edge is not consistent. And we're gonna look at that later on. However, in order to do this, I'm actually not gonna use the parameters on the right-hand side. What I'm going to do instead is to just right click on this effect, and in the menu, select ungroup. So this is actually going to just unpack. It's going to show you everything that goes into the making of this effect. So the first thing we're gonna do here is to click on Erode Dilate, and then just bump up the amount setting here. This is just going to increase the border there, make it look more pronounced throughout this entire clip. It's already looking way much better. However, one thing you are noticing is that this paper look is still not consistent throughout the rest of this clip. So that is one thing we're going to look at next. So now let's click on the Displace node. And the first thing we're gonna do here is to switch the type from the dial to XY. And then we're going to change the X channel and Y channel both to Luma. We're also going to change the X offset and the Y offset setting both to negative 0.5 by simply just dragging them all the way to the left. And then we're going to start to bring down the X refraction setting there as well as the Y refraction setting. So as we're making these changes, notice how on the screen this is impacting the paper look and how it's changing as a result of us making changes to these settings. So this is where you can really make your own look, create your own look by picking back off of an existing template in DaVinci Resolve. Now, I'm just going to continue to make changes to the refraction settings there in order to make this effect look more consistent throughout this entire clip. And I think this is now looking way much better, so I'm going to stick with these settings. All right, lastly, we're going to add some texture to this effect. And to do this, I'm going to bring in a very blurred node and then just plug it in between the merge node and the displace node. So now let's come to the very blur node here, switch the method to soften, and then we're going to first of all bring up the quality setting there a bit there to 7, and then let's just start to bring up the blur size. And right away on the screen, if you have a look, this is just going to add some discoloration there to the borders, to the edges. And it just looks way much better as a result. It looks way more natural. And you did all this, you can do all this without using any external files whatsoever. So this is looking way much better and I'm going to go with this. So let's come back to the edit page here. And you're gonna see that we pretty much have our custom paper effect. However, one thing you are noticing is that there's no stop motion, which is an essential part of this effect. So let's go back to the Fusion page here. What we're gonna do is to just bring in a stop motion mode, and we're going to add it between the polygon node and the matte control node. So let's just make sure we plug that in there in between these nodes. And then what we're gonna do is just simply come to the setting there, and then we're going to change it from 5 to 3. And right away, if we were to play this right now, you guys will notice that now we have this stop motion effect added on top of it, and it just brings everything together as an effect. So now let's just take it back to the edit page, let this effect render, and you guys will see that this is pretty much it. This is looking really good, and you can really customize this any way you want. So let's go back to the Fusion page here real quick. And one of the ways you can customize this is by playing with the polygon masking node, create a different look, play with these points on the screen, and really sky is your limit. So yeah, this is pretty much it, you guys. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and as always, I will see you next time.